What's up, you guys? It's Sarah at carnivore.yogi on Instagram. Thank you so much for coming back to my YouTube channel and clicking on today's video. In this video, I'm gonna be showing you what I eat in a day, as well as the routines that I do throughout the day and before bed to optimize my sleep. So if that kind of content interests you, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And before I get into any of that, my typical disclaimer, I am not a doctor, nutritionist, expert, any of that stuff. I am just sharing my journey with you guys. I am a big believer in testing things on yourself to see what works best for you, to work optimally for you. So that's really what this whole channel is about. And speaking of testing things out, I'm really excited, you guys, because I'm about to do this test with this company, Thrive. It is a gut health test. Now, it will test your gut microbiome, which I've been really interested in because since switching to a carnivore diet, my gut health has been amazing. Like, I've been really feeling the best that I felt in my whole life. And I really want to see what this test has to say. I also think that your gut microbiome health will absolutely influence your sleep. Going from a standard American diet to a carnivore diet, I experienced a huge difference in my sleep. And then a standard carnivore diet to a high-fat carnivore diet, which is what I will show you today, I experienced an even greater difference in my sleep. So I'm gonna do this gut health test, you guys. You're definitely gonna wanna subscribe to the channel because I will be sharing the results with you when I get them back. The other cool thing about this gut health test, you guys, is that they will take your personal gut health sample and formulate a probiotic for you that you can take. So I'm gonna take you along on this whole journey. And who knows, maybe my sleep will be optimized even more after doing this gut health experiment. So let's jump right into the food, what I ate today. You guys know I'm a huge fan of meat broth, and you can click the little eye up there in the corner if you want my meat broth recipe, how I do it. But for today's intents and purposes, I'm gonna eliminate anything that could be a histamine aggravation. So I'm gonna use half a tablespoon of rendered beef suet in my meat broth with some salt, of course, for breakfast. I also, on the side of this for breakfast, I'm gonna have 2 tablespoons of my rendered beef suet. Now again, if you're interested in how to render fat down, check out my video having to do with fat. So that is my breakfast. Now, here's the thing about eating high-fat carnivore. It's not a lot of food, you guys, and I've talked about this before. You know, you're going to have a smaller volume of food and it's a different feeling of fullness. It's not that big, huge feeling in your stomach, the volume feeling that you would get from eating a couple of ribeyes. It's much different, but I am satisfied, I am satiated. So today's meals, and this is what I love to do, because if something's not simple, I'm not gonna stick to it. If it's very complicated, I'm in the kitchen all day, it's just not gonna happen. So today what I decided to do was just have a diet of thymus and some bison fat. So the way that I prepared this thymus was this morning after I had my meat broth, got a little settled into the day, I went ahead and I took the thymus out of the package, dried it out, and then I popped it into the air fryer for 15 minutes and it was all cooked through and through. Then I measured it out. This came out to roughly 6.5 ounces. I will translate into grams for people who are not in the United States. And then I took the bison fat that I had in my freezer. I've had it for a while and I cut it up on my cutting board and I portioned it out, also about 6.5 ounces. Now, why thymus? Sweetbreads, right, is what they're commonly called. This particular food, as well as kidney, which I'm not a huge fan of beef kidney, but I do like lamb kidney. But kidney and thymus are both going to help your body produce more of the DAO enzyme, which is the enzyme for, it's creating your small intestine, and what it will do is help your body to break down histamines. Now, I didn't know until I went really more so on a strict carnivore elimination diet that histamines have been a huge problem for me my whole life. So I have a lot more videos coming about histamine, and I've done histamine videos in the past with Dr. Becky Campbell. But essentially, eating thymus, now I do take the desiccated thymus as well, the Ancestral Supplements desiccated thymus, but eating thymus is so much more powerful. I find that my sleep is way better, I feel better just from eating the organ. So anytime you can eat the actual organ, go for it. And thymus to me tastes like kind of a chicken thigh, but it's a lot chewier. So it is a different texture if you're not used to it, but I really, really, truly enjoy it. So my meals today, very simple, you guys, just thymus and bison fat, easy. Like I said, if it's not easy, I'm probably not gonna stick to it. And I do feel very satiated, even though it's a small amount of food. The thymus is extremely high in fat, and of course you're eating pure bison beef fat. Now this is raw, it's been in my freezer for probably a couple of months now, so I'm not really worried about bacteria, I just eat it raw. You could also saute it on the stove in a cast iron if you wanted to, but I just prefer to eat it fat. I'm actually more satiated and it is better on my digestion when I just eat that fat raw. Okay, so there's the food. Let's talk about my daily routines, things that I do on a daily basis to optimize my sleep at night, because it's not just like you do a few things before bed and have great sleep. Now those things can help, which I'll talk to you about, but I think it's your whole entire lifestyle. So every day when I wake up, I have a meditation. I have a 20-minute meditation as soon as I wake up. And when I started meditating over 2 years ago, that was the first thing that helped me to come off of sleeping medication. So there's a book I will link below this video called Bliss More by my teacher, Leight Watkins. And it gave me the beginner technique to start meditating on my own without any apps, without any assistance, has been extremely helpful. So that meditation as soon as I wake up, and then I do another meditation session for 20 minutes in the afternoon around 2:30 or so. That is something that I do during the day. Another thing that I do during the day every day is try to get some sort of sunlight. So I love to go out on long walks in the sun. I love to expose myself to sunlight when I first wake up. I just go outside, look up at the sun, expose my eyes to that light with no sunglasses on, not looking through a window, just look right at that light. It helps with that circadian rhythm aspect, which is very, very important when we're looking at sleep. Another thing that I do is cold therapy. Now you can do a cold shower, which I really don't like. You can also do cryotherapy, which I have done in the past, but I love my cold vest. Now I will link the one that I use below as well as give you guys a discount code for that. But I do wear my cold vest, not every day, but I do wear it, and I notice that the nights that I wear it, I see 30 to 45 minutes more of deep sleep per night when I track my Oura Ring data. So that's very interesting. Really, my biggest benefit to doing any sort of cold therapy is more deep sleep and faster falling asleep. It's just amazing what cold therapy can do. So sure, I'm sure it helps you burn calories and it turns your white fat into brown fat. But the biggest benefit for me of cold therapy is that deeper sleep. So I always recommend people just try maybe a cold shower, or if you're interested in taking it a step further, the cold vest is an amazing addition to your sleep hygiene routine. All right, so let's get into what I start doing at night. So I turn off my devices starting at 7 o'clock, and that takes a lot of discipline for me, but no more devices after 7 p.m. I will let myself watch a little bit of TV, but I try to wind that down at least an hour before bed. So what I love to do before bed is take a really nice warm bath. I do use Epsom salt. So 2 cups of Epsom salt, sometimes a little baking soda, and just a nice warm relaxing bath. Now while I'm in the bath, I listen to a guided meditation, and I will link a couple of them below, the ones that I really enjoy, but, and I've already meditated during the day. So this is a different form of relaxation when you actually have a guide. The type of meditation I do, I'm just doing it, no apps, no guides, it's all self-directed. But this is nice, just, it kind of talks me into winding down. And so I'll do that in the bath, and then typically those meditations are like an hour long. So once I get out of the bath, get dried down, I will use my Fancy Farm lotion. That is my absolute favorite. It's a treat. I put it on my face. I also put it on my feet. I don't know if you're supposed to do that, but I do. And I'm absolutely obsessed with vetiver oil. I buy the doTERRA brand. I'm not a rep for them, so I don't have a link for that. But if you know, if you guys are doTERRA reps, you can put your information in the comments below so people can reach out to you. But I put vetiver oil on my wrists as well as on the soles of my feet. And then I love to prop my hips up against the wall, put my legs up against the wall, And I will just lay there and listen to that guided meditation for 10, 15 minutes, sometimes even longer, just depending on how much I actually need to wind down on that particular day. Some other things that I have in play just to kind of, for my overall sleep hygiene routine, I have blackout curtains in the bedroom. I turn the air conditioning, or I turn the thermostat, because now we're into fall here, turn the thermostat on 66, which is pretty cold, but my family hasn't complained yet. My husband actually really enjoys it. So the room is really dark, it's really cold. I also have special light bulbs, which I will link below this video, that I have put only in the bedroom and the bathrooms of the house. So if we're waking up in the night to go to the bathroom, then the light bulbs that come on are non-blue light. So they're blue, they block out all the blue light, so they don't give your brain that same signal as a regular fluorescent or an LED light bulb does. It actually, these light bulbs don't block the production of melatonin, which is the hormone that you need to fall asleep. So I do have those special light bulbs in the bedroom and in the bathrooms as well. I also like to keep my bedtime pretty much the same every single night, because I find that that just gives my body those clues and it falls into that sleeping pattern. I try to go to sleep before 10 o'clock at night, because there are these like waves that you want to catch. And if you can catch a wave, you're going to get your deep sleep between usually, you know, 9 p.m., 10 p.m. and 2 a.m. And then that REM sleep will happen more in those earlier hours of the morning. So I am careful to get to bed early, because that deep sleep is really where your body does a lot of that repair work for it, that hard repair work where you're resting, restoring, burning fat. All that stuff is really important. So you want to optimize that deep sleep. Now the cold vest as well also optimizes that deep sleep for me. I don't see a big difference in my REM sleep with the cold vest, but I do with the deep sleep. REM sleep still pretty much stays the same. A couple supplements that I do use to optimize my sleep are magnesium glycinate before bed. Occasionally I will take PS100 as well if I'm having a lot of stress happen in my life, because that's very good for helping to cut down cortisol. But the biggest thing for me is just knowing what keeps me awake. So anytime, and I turn my phone on airplane mode, keep it beside my bed on airplane mode. I don't look at it in the night. If I wake up and I have to pee, I don't look at my phone at all, even to see what time it is. I'm really strict with that, because that will turn on your brain. That light from your phone will turn on your brain. It will stop that melatonin production. And also it's going to distract you. It's going to put thoughts in your head that you don't necessarily need. I'm also a big fan of alternate nostril breathing if you need that little extra bit of relaxation. And I haven't started it yet, but I did just buy some mouth tape after watching my friend health coach Kate's video about mouth taping. So I have some, but I haven't used it yet. My sleep is really, really good though, after really implementing a lot of these things and then really getting rid of the stuff that aggravates my histamine intolerance. So if I eat too much butter, I have problems where I'll wake up all night. If I eat leftovers, sometimes that will aggravate my histamine. Dairy is a huge one. So any kind of cheese or cream absolutely aggravates my histamine issues. Now, the external things I can't control, like the change in weather, the, you know, mold outside, that kind of stuff, that's where I do have to add in that thymus and eat the kidney and supplement in those ways, because during the fall and during the spring, the histamines are going to be worse for me because I'm sensitive to them. I have not been formally diagnosed with mast cell activation, but I do have a sneaking suspicion that that's something that my body has. So eat my liver, eat my thymus, eat my kidney, right? Do all of these things, and my sleep is just amazing. Now, this is coming from someone who was addicted to sleeping medication for 20 plus years. I was able to come off of sleeping medication through twice daily meditation. That was the first thing that I did. And then later in, I added in carnivore diet, and later on I turned that into a high fat carnivore diet, which I think is optimized by adding in these different glands and organs. It helps me a lot. So I hope that this was helpful, you guys. Lots of information in this video. Feel free to drop a question below, or if there's another video that you would like me to do in the future, I'm happy to do it. Just drop it below and I will put it into consideration. So again, hope this was helpful, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.